Hello, welcome at Mount Game Coding. In our latest Unity Space Invaders video, one could make the argument that we kinda cheated, hacked, or took the shortcut when applying the rigid body 2D to our invader and other game objects. So let's take a look at it, what Unity has to say about it, and how we can do it in a more proper way. So let's dive in. So I already checked out the Space Invaders Unity version. So I cloned it and I opened it. And let's go to where we left off the last time. So in the last video, we made an invader, which looks like a square, red square. And we have a bullet and we have a spaceship. And if you go to the components, for example, the player inside the world, it has a rigid body 2D and a box collider. The box collider is used as a trigger. So we get a trigger event in code, which will notify us when the player collides or intersects with another collision object. So another object which has a rigid body 2D component and a collider component. So if you go to the rigid body 2D component, in the previous video we set the gravity and the angular drag and the linear drag and the mass to 0 or 1. So it has no influence on the rigid body. But Unity has already created body types which can do that for you, and which is much more efficient, because now the calculations are still calculated, which requires CPU time. And if you use one of the other body types, they don't. The calculations are not executed. So that's more optimal. So what are these body types? We can see there is the option for dynamic, kinematic, or static. And if we go to the reference, the Unity reference guide on rigid body 2D and the manual on colliders, we can see all the information. So let's do that. So here you can see it explains the body types, and the different body types are these three body types. And it says that the option you choose defines the movement, position, rotation, behavior, and collider interaction. And so that's determined by the preferred body type. So the most advanced body type is the dynamic body type, and it reacts to all the physics in the physics engine. So it's the most performance expensive body type to use. So you want to use this body type if you want your game object to be influenced by all the physics in your game. For example, if you do not want that, then maybe the kinematic or the static are a better choice. So in our game, we don't want, and the Space Invaders game, we don't want the spaceship or the invader or the bullet to be influenced by all the physics, for example gravity. So we don't want to use the most performance expensive body type. Let's see. So we have kinematic. And so, wow, a dynamic rigid body 2D is affected by gravity and forces. A kinematic rigid body 2D isn't. For this reason, it is fast and has a lower demand on the system resources than a dynamic rigid body 2D. And so the manual explains all of this. And as last, you have the static. It's a rigid body 2D is designed to not move under simulation at all. If anything collides with it, instead a rigid body 2D behaves like an immovable object, as though it has infinite mass. And the least resource intensive body type. So let's look at some examples when you would like to use which body type. So we can start with Mario. So we have Mario, and you have these platforms which move down. You have these blocks that are like the ground. And those are the different objects. So we could see that the ground, it cannot be destroyed. It is always there, and Mario can always move on it, as well as the enemies. So these are perfectly suitable for static, for the static body type. These movable platforms, they move a little bit, and they go, come from downwards up or from upwards down, and Mario can collide with them. The static ground does not collide with them; they do not overlap. But you can use, for example, the kinematic. Body type for these platforms, and also Mario. And in this game, Mario has some animation, but it doesn't react. It does react to some kind of gravity, right? It moves down again every time it jumps up. But if Mario is hit, it doesn't. The bullet, for example, does not push Mario back. And then he's hit, and he shrinks, and animation kicks in, or he dies, and he falls off the screen. And so there's no full physics inside Mario. And they have some formulas to make it make believe. So let's look at another example. Here you can see an example made by Pair 2. A name I'm unable to pronounce. So let's start the video and see what happens here. So we have this character. First it's in animation, and there's an animation standing up. Then the user applies some force at a certain location, and the character falls. And the way it falls, it looks very real. Like somebody could fall in real life. So that's simulated by the physics engine. So he applies a force, for example. Let's wait until it stands up. So we will apply the force at its arm, and the arm will be pushed back, and it will drag the rest of the body with it in a very convincing way. So that's switching between animation and physics. And the character is a ragdoll, and you can use Unity to switch between those states. Let's see. It explains it to us somewhere. Yeah, here. A rigid body component can be switched between normal and kinematic behavior at any time using the isKinematic property. So in code, you can use the isKinematic property to switch between dynamic body type and kinematic body type. So for example, you have a character, the character is running around, then there's a big explosion, the character is hit by the explosion, and you want to have this character behave in a very realistic way. So it's being blown away by the explosion, and it will move as if the real world physics or some fictional physics affect that character. So you switch it from animation, which is very user controlled, to a very physics controlled state, which the whole body moves around according to the forces being applied. So that's where this function is for. Also, if you go to the Collider's manual and you go to the collision action matrix, you can see how the different colliders, depending on the body type, affect each other or react to each other. So for example, static colliders, if you have two different objects, for example, at this stone and this stone, because they never move, they're always there. They don't need to have, they can use the static collider the least performance intensive one. The static objects, because they don't move, they can never touch each other. And if they don't touch each other, you don't need to make calculations to see if they touch each other, because they're standing still. So that's why they don't collide. So for example, a rigid body or a kinematic rigid body collider, they move around the level, so they can hit static colliders. Although I see that Unity kinematic rigid body colliders do not collide with static colliders. So there's only a collision event between static colliders and rigid body colliders. And rigid body colliders collide with static rigid body and other kinematic rigid body colliders. And so you can use this matrix to see if you have two objects, is it possible for them to overlap or have contact in the game? If so, then I need to make sure that I have set the right body type, not the ones that could collide. So here we can see that there is no collision between kinematic and static, or kinematic and other kinematic rigid body colliders. For the triggers, it's different. So we have the colliders and we have the triggers. And here we can see that we can enable a collider as a trigger. And if we enable it as a trigger, the different options become available. So you get an on-trigger event. The event we use here, you get an on collision event. So let's see. These bottom three are the triggers. So static trigger, rigid body trigger, kinematic rigid body trigger. And we can see that a static trigger collider does not generate an event with a static collider or with a static trigger collider. But the rigid body trigger collider, well, it generates a event, an on-trigger event, with all type of body, with all body type. And the kinematic rigid body trigger collider also generates an event with all other body types. Now, whether it's a collider or something set as trigger. And if something is set as trigger, it will generate a trigger message event. And this is the one we would like to use for our game, because we don't want the physics to be involved. And we didn't want to use the angular drag or the gravity, but our objects move. They move around, and they might touch each other: the bullet and the enemy, or the enemy and the spaceship. So let's change our settings. So we go to the player, we select body type, we choose kinematic, and you also see the properties disappear. If you choose static, even more properties disappear. So we keep simulated on, so the events will be triggered, otherwise the events will be turned off. And the same for our enemy, and the same for our bullet. So let's run the game. Okay, here you can see. So let's see, we put the bullet simulation off. It will not hit this enemy. And if you put simulated on, but static, let's see what it does. And that one works as well. Okay, so static, if the bullet is static and the enemy is kinematic, let's go to the matrix. So for example, the bullet was static, the enemy was kinematic, so they will hit each other, because the enemy can touch static objects, so this will generate a trigger event. And so you can optimize it a little bit further, even if you would like, let's say you have multiple bullets and you want the bullets to touch each other, you don't want to set it to static. Same with enemies, if they should touch each other, you should choose kinematic. If the enemies cannot touch each other and it might stand still, you want kinematic. So for now, I put it on kinematic. So kinematic is the better choice for our Space Invaders game than the dynamic. If you want to use gravity and the physics engine, use dynamic. Okay, I will commit this, and thank you for watching. Make sure to subscribe, leave your comments, give us your feedback, and see you in another video. Have a good day.